Are you incubating your eggs correctly? Stick around and find out. Welcome to This or That, where we compare products common to the hobby to find out which is best for you. Incubation is one of the most challenging aspects of breeding reptiles. Today, we're going to compare suspended incubation versus substrate incubation to help you choose which is right for you. Suspended incubation is when eggs are held by a tray or a dry substrate above wet substrate, while substrate incubation is when eggs are directly deposited into moistened substrate. Let's start with the products we'll be comparing today. There's a lot of methods to use suspended incubation. You can use dry substrate in a container above wet substrate or one of the multiple tray products available on the market. Today, we're going to be using a suspended tray method, specifically the Redline Science BioHatch tray. There's many substrates used for reptile incubation, like perlite, vermiculite, but today we're gonna use a clay substrate, Pangea Hatch. Tell us in the comments what products you use to incubate and why, we'd love to find out. Let's go over the comparison criteria for these two products. We're gonna be talking about risk of mold and contamination, humidity retention, hatchling safety, soft egg versus hard egg, and cost. But we want to know what products and criteria do you want to see us compare in the future? So let us know in the comments. Now for a detailed comparison of these products. For risk of mold contamination, suspended incubation is generally better at mitigating unwanted mold contamination than eggs deposited in a wet substrate. The organic egg does not touch wet substrate and allows air to flow all around the egg, preventing excess moisture and subsequent mold. For humidity retention, direct substrate depositing offers higher humidity retention than suspended generally. The proximity of direct contact ensures eggs are kept as hydrated as possible, while the elevation and separation of suspended incubation does not. For hatchling safety, generally speaking, both of these methods are quite safe for your hatchling. However, some substrates like vermiculite can be sticky and the risk of ingestion is higher with a direct substrate contact method using that substrate. For soft eggs versus hard eggs, hard shell reptile eggs like that of many arid and temperate species are better suspended because they are more susceptible to mold and rot from excess moisture. Soft shell eggs, which are often from tropical and subtropical species, typically fare better in moist substrate where they can maintain humidity as their egg respirates. There are definitely exceptions to this, so make sure you talk to an experienced breeder about your species needs. And finally, let's compare cost. Each of these methods is about the same, with the hatch plus tray combo being about 83 cents and the Redline Science kit being about 88 cents per egg for crested geckos. Each product can be sanitized and reused, so we're gonna ignore the repurchasing cost. Speaking of cost, we will have a coupon code for these products at the end, so stick around so you can save on the cost for these. Let's talk pros and cons for these methods. Suspended egg incubation is fantastic at preventing mold and rot, especially in hard-shelled eggs from arid and temperate reptiles. The air circulation that helps prevent mold can also dry out eggs if high humidity is not maintained, causing indentations and even collapse. Direct substrate depositing is excellent for species that require high humidity, but this contact with wet substrate can cause problems with mold if your substrate is too wet or your air circulation is too low. We have used this method to successfully hatch thousands of crested gecko eggs, as well as many New Caledonian species. So here are recommendations for these products. If you have a high humidity needing species with soft eggs, consider the advantages of direct substrate depositing. But if you have hard-shelled eggs from a species that does not need as much humidity, then consider the advantages of suspended incubation. Tell us your experience with either of these methods in the comments, because we would love to hear more from you our customers and fellow community members. And of course, you can find all of these products at pangeareptile.com, and you can use the coupon code HATCH10 to receive 10% off your first order of any of these products. Thanks for watching. Give a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. Subscribe for more content like this, and let us know in the comments what species you breed or are interested in breeding. See you next time. Thank you.